Hi everyone, this is Brendan here. Welcome to my next episode, day 36 of my Let's Clash series. So let's start the episode by watching this interesting defensive replay that occurred on my base. So if you guys watch carefully how this guy is deploying his barbarians and archers, I'm not too sure how exactly is he deploying, especially the barbarians and archers in this particular manner, like in just one big entire group. So I'm not too sure whether it's like kind of like a boat or whatsoever thing that he's using. I'm not trying to pinpoint him or accuse him on anything, but I'm finding that this is an interesting way of deploying his troops. So it's kind of a very efficient way to deploy the troops. I'm not too sure whether I'm able to do it because I did try with my other account using some barge and I did try to deploy it on the Sherbet Towers map, but I can't seem to do it as fast as he did. Maybe he tapped the screen really quickly. I'm not too sure how exactly he did it, but yeah, it was quite an interesting and also a very efficient method, as now you can see he used barbarians and archers and some giants together with some wall breakers and of course with his barbarian king behind to 3-star my base. So he did it in a very really interesting method. That's all I gotta say. So yeah, that's it for that particular raid that actually occurred on my base that I found really interesting, especially when that's something that I've never seen on my whole entire of Clash history. So stay in the comments what you guys think about that particular defensive replay, because I found that really interesting. So going ahead to do my very own attack, and of course going ahead to just focus on the gold mines. The gold mines are just my priority, not focusing on the rest of the stuff, although my elixir is kind of 50% right now, but I don't have really much bother about it because I'm not using it to upgrade any stuff. I did upgrade my dark elixir storage the day before, so of course my elixir has depleted a bit. So I'm just gonna do a bit of the raiding, and of course the elixir will just replenish back on its own, although I'm gonna focus more on the gold mine. But whenever I try to go for 50%, I'll try to clear most of the buildings, and then eventually I also have to take out the elixir collectors. So now going ahead to focus on the gold mines again. The gold mines are pretty spread out for this particular base, so I have to play my troops really well, drop them in those position whereby they can actually take out the gold mines, especially the one on the left side whereby the archers have swung to the army camp over there, and then the gold mine didn't get taken out, so I had to drop some minions to try to take that gold mine out. So I just left with 0 gold left. So going ahead to take a look at where I could get another 1%, because 1 more percent will actually get me the win. So on the top there was a free builder hub, so I've already dropped an archer over there. So in order to speed things up, I just dropped my Barbarian King, which is going to go down right now. So just taking one swipe and it just got taken out, scoring us the 1 star 50%. So going ahead with the very next attack on this 305,000 gold available base. Not too much on the elixir, but I'm just gonna go ahead to get the gold as usual. So focusing on the gold is really not too difficult, especially when the number of troops that you have to use ain't too much, because to take out the gold mines, you just have to use a small amount of troops. If you're gonna take out like say 50% of the base, then you might have to use more of your troops. So in order to just take out 6 gold mines for this particular Town Hall 8 that has 6 gold mines, it's not too difficult, although they have a lot of splash dealing defenses such as the Mota, which are very strong against Barbarians and Archers, especially when Barbarians and Archers, they are being able to be taken out by 1 hit or 2 hits of the Mota as they do splash damage. So wasn't able to get the 1 star, so I just lost the raid. So found this base with actually 170 over 1000 gold, and then I just decided to just go ahead to take out the gold mines, just spending a few of my troops, not gonna spam all of them out, especially when the town is quite well protected, and I suspect that there are some Teslas over there, so I didn't want to take my chance to waste my troops to go for it. So I know some of you guys will be thinking, why don't you just go ahead and take the town? I mean, it looks pretty easy to take. But I mean, you take into consideration that if I were to use all my troops to just get this base, get 170 over 1000 gold, and then just getting the town hall, it just doesn't make sense. I would rather just search for a few more bases and just snipe the town hall to get my trophies back up. At the same time, getting the bonus loot, although I have to just spend a few more minutes searching for a base, but at the same time while searching for a town hall to snipe, I'm also searching for bases to raid, such as this one that has just appeared. So going ahead to take out the gold mines and dropping my clan castle on the top right, clan castle containing one giant and 5 wizards. So I feel that having 1 giant and 5 wizards is really efficient, especially when the giant, they do take a lot of hits and they do a lot of damage too at the same time. So the wizards just behind are doing a lot of damage, especially against those kind of bases which has the mortar and also the wizards towers back against the wall. So as the giants will just protect the wizards from the damage of the mortar and also the wizard towers. So that's something that I really like, especially having the giant to just soak up the damage and not have my wizards be taken out that quickly. So some of you guys, if you guys want to try out this clan castle combination, do try it out, and I'm pretty sure you guys will like it too as much as I have. So now it's going back to the raid, as now you can see this guy has some troops in the clan castle, and of course the clan castle troop has distracted my troops, and now my troops I do have to deploy some more to try to take out the gold mine, which actually got the job done and took out the extra gold mine to get the extra more gold. So going ahead to the very next attack on this tower 7 with 191,000 gold available. Although the gold ain't too much, but then it's a very easy raid to attack. So now as you can see, I just dropped some minions around the sides and the corners, taking out their 4 gold mines, and I'm just not spending too much troops. Now dropping my barbarians and archers to take out their remaining 2 gold mines. So now as you can see, this is the really useful thing about having some minions, which is the cannon and also the mortar. They can't do any damage to the minions, so the minions just have to just take out the gold mines. As they are flying troops, so they won't be able to be taken out by those ground attacking defenses only. So now on the left side, I've dropped one minion to take out that gold mine. The cannon won't be able to take out the minion, although I could have dropped one archer because the range of the cannon won't be far enough to reach the minion. So it's not to worry, the other minion is still usable. So going ahead to try to clear out some of the structures on the bottom side first, so that I could have a clear entry point for the left side, the gold mine. So now dropping my minions flying in to take out the gold mine over there, because the gold mine, it looks very full, especially there are actually 2 gold mines over there. So now taking out one of the gold mine and then just taking out the second one on the left side. So left with 50,000 gold with that gold mine in the center over there. So it's pretty hard to go for it because the range of the wizard won't be able to take out the gold mine, and the wizards have to break through the wall to go ahead to take out that gold mine. And now my giant ain't going the right way. It's going on top to try to take out the defense. There ain't any more defense for it to go over there. So now the Barbarian King has gone over there to take out my wizards. My wizards ain't doing a good job because there was kind of a little lag time whereby the wizard didn't do his second shot to take out the Barbarian King, but then the archer managed to take out the Barbarian King, which was really good. So going ahead with the next attack, now with this 290,000 gold available base, and just going ahead to maybe take out some more of the structures first so that I could clear more of the side, the right side especially, where there are 2 gold mines over there. So the thing about how to focus your troops at one particular spot, the thing is you have to clear the sides first before your main bulk of your troops, such as currently which are my wizards, they're gonna go into the center. So next time when I actually use a Goby Wipe to show you guys some Goby Wipe raids, especially for a war, I will explain more in detail as to how to deploy your troops, as what to look out for, especially those buildings on the left and the right side. You have to clear those first before your main bulk of your troops, such as your P.e.k.k.a, such as your Barbarian King and your Queen, goes down to actually go into the core of the base, as you do not want them to go to the side, which they won't be able to take out the town hall, as usually the town hall will be in the middle. So the way as to how to deploy, you have to clear the sides first. Eventually, then after that, they will go inside to take out the rest of the remaining structures in the core. So now as you can see, I'm going to take out this base with just 180,000 gold on the left side. The gold mines, they're all situated on the left side, which is just an easy raid. Not going to spread my troops out like how I did just now. So just ending the battle in just a few more seconds. After that, just going ahead to just lose it. So now going ahead with the very next attack on this tower 7. It's going to be a very interesting attack. So now as you can see, I dropped my barbarians and archers, and then following up by my minions, my level 1 minions in fact, dropping my clan castle which contained my usual attacking army combo, and then dropping my barbarian king which is going to help out a lot. And I have 3 spells available with me, 1 lightning spell and 2 rage spell. They are level 1, so they ain't going to do a lot of damage, but the speed that they actually contribute to boost my heroes, especially my troops also, especially my archers. They will be able to survive the blast from the mortar, especially the mortar will miss them, so they won't get too much damage from the mortar, especially also taking into consideration that the mortar level ain't too high, so they won't be able to take out the archers in like one shot. So going ahead now, the giant ain't doing too much of a good job. His lagging behind, especially just now when he was hitting against the wall. So now as you can see, I've cleared like 90%+ of the base, so it's gonna be a 3-star raid just left now with the clan castle over there to just take out. So we're left with some of the archers taking out the clan castle, scoring us the 3-star with 190,000 gold stolen. So yeah, that was a very interesting 3-star that I've not done in a very long time. So now I'm going here with the very next attack, is 290,000 gold available. This is also a very interesting attack now. As you can see, I dropped some minions on the outside first, taking out all those structures whereby the minions won't be taken out, especially when the archer towers, they in place properly, that's one. And also the air defenses, they were placed quite into the core of the bases. Although as you can see, next to the town hall, there were like two areas whereby actually I could deploy my troops, but I kind of suspected that there were some traps over there, especially some Teslas. So I didn't bother to try to take the town hall, and also they had the clan castle and also the king and queen over there. So my troops would get distracted, especially with such low level barbarians and archers. I didn't think that that was a good idea to try to take out the town hall. So I was just going my way, taking out the structures on the outside first, having a slight confidence that I'll be able to get a 1-star, although it's a town hall 9. And a lot of the structures, they weren't well too protected, especially by air attacks. So now the minions, they are doing a really good job taking out a lot of the structures. Now on the left side, the gold mine has already been sniped out by one of the minions, although it is only level 1, but the damage dealt by the minions is still pretty high enough to do even higher damage than one archer. So going ahead now to clear out the right side too, there's another gold mine over there. And then the bottom side, I did drop some minions to try to clear out some of the buildings also. So now as you can see, I dropped my barbarians and archers trying to go for the last two gold mines over there. So the last two gold mines, they are definitely going to go down. So I was kind of lucky that the expo didn't have any ammo left, so I didn't have to worry about those two expo over there. So managed to get a 1-star and stole 291,000 gold from the base. So going ahead, the very next attack with 168,000 gold available. Not too high, but not too difficult base to attack to, especially when the gold mines, they are all just outside and the gold mine contain almost all the gold. So going ahead to try to clear out the gold mines, and then just left with a little bit of the gold, and I didn't manage to clear it all, but not to worry, I stole majority of it. So going back to my base, my elixir storage has just completed its upgrade, so now I have 3 million elixir capacity, which is really nice. Gonna use all my gold to upgrade the walls, but of course left with 500,000 to try to conserve some of it so that I could do some raids. So gonna remove the 3 over there, which is gonna take 15 seconds, so I have 15 seconds to do a raid. But of course I won't be able to do the raid in 15 seconds, so I'll take the time to actually search for a raid at the same time, do a raid, and then just get a bit of the gold to get it above 550,000 so that I could have enough gold to do a few searches later. So going ahead to take out this Town Hall 8 with a little bit of the gold. Not too much, but I'm pretty sure I will be able to get more than 50,000 from the gold mines itself. So I've stole already now 80,000 from this base. So it's definitely going to reach like 600,000. So now as you can see, the last gold mine on the right side has gotten me to 600,000 gold. So we're gonna just end the raid and just defeat it myself. And going back to my base, and now you can see I'm gonna remove one of the trunk. The trunk on the left side is gonna be removed in just a few seconds. So let's fast forward a bit, removing the trunk and getting one gem. The top, there's also another trunk. I'm gonna remove it and get 3 gems from it. So going ahead to upgrade my wall with the remaining gold that I left with 104,000 gold left. Gonna upgrade a few more walls, 29,000 gold left. Gonna upgrade a few more of my walls again. So this is why I actually save up my low level walls, not gonna upgrade them to a higher level sooner enough, so that I could slowly upgrade them as to spend my gold wisely, so that later when I go offline, when people attack me, they will see that I have very little gold to attack, and they might not even 3-star me, they might even just snipe my tower and just run away. So I'm gonna upgrade my gold storage, it's gonna take 2 days to upgrade, and I'm gonna increase my capacity to 6 million. So now as you can see, I've actually farmed so much that today I've gotten majority of the flags. In fact, I've just left with only one flag. So as mentioned in my previous episodes, I'm getting the flags so that I could use them as another gold storage. So now as you can see, I've gotten 130 level 8 walls, more than 50% of the walls that I actually have. So now going ahead to take a look at my game center. So some of you guys have added me on the game center, and of course I do appreciate that. So I'll still be awaiting some of you guys to add me. I'm trying to get it to 500, and of course first come first serve basis, for those of you who can't add me, especially on my main account, I'm sorry about that again. But do add me on my third account, especially for those who are interested in tracking me and looking for me, especially when I'm gonna change clan sooner or later. And of course, do not spy on me too much because it will make the episode not too interesting for you guys. So some of you have stated that you guys do track down my account and of course do check on my progress. Then after that, when you guys watch the episode, you guys can already predict what I'm going to do, what I'm going to upgrade and what I'm going to kind of farm. So it makes the episode less interesting. So I do not suggest you guys to keep spying on me. Of course, you guys can do come on to my clan to have a chat with me if my co-leaders and the leaders do allow that. So that's up to them to decide. So yeah, that's it for this particular episode that I'd like to update you guys on. Hope you guys have enjoyed it. So if that's it, I'd like to thank you guys for watching my episode and clash on.